flights all go to Alicante, which is just over 2 hours from London Gatwick, just over 3 from Glasgow. Then it's another hour by coach to Benidorm, and it's Benidorm which is the one thing the holidays all have in common.
The history of the packaged holiday is written 20 stories high along the front at Benidorm. The classic tale you'll find repeated the length of the Spanish coast is spelled out here in capitals. Once there was a fishing village. In Benidorm, it was in the middle of an enormous beach. But what the villagers didn't know was that the day would come when all the fish in their sea would be worth but an atom of the sand where they landed their catches. Now the narrow streets of the old town are strictly conserved. Beyond the old town, Benidorm has erupted into a massive international resort, whose sand and streets are fastidiously swept, and whose cafes and bars these days have slightly fewer advertisements for English breakfasts and British beer and tea like mother makes. Benidorm has moved on, but the packaged holidays that built it seem to have gone back to square one.
Three new companies have come on the scene in the last few years. They're selling what they call no-frills holidays in hotels and apartments all round the Mediterranean. So what corners are they cutting with their costs and what are their customers getting for their money? We've been looking at these companies which, though you may not realise it, have been set up by the biggest and best-known names in the business.
Lancaster Holidays was the first. They're part of the same group as Intersun. The Birmingham-based Horizon Company was next on the scene with Broadway.
You can go there all day long.
Then last year, the biggest group of all, Thomson, launched Sky Tours. You won't find the name Thomson in the brochure, but with Sky Tours, they intend to win the reputation as the cheapest of the lot. The choice between them starts with the flight, and that's where the savings start too. It may well be the flight that in the end decides which holiday you buy. It all depends on your priorities, convenience or cost.
For a start, the companies don't all fly to Alicante from the same UK airports. Only four are common to them all: Gatwick, Manchester, Luton and Glasgow. Lancaster have the most airports, 13, and Broadway the fewest, just the four.
Having worked out from where you're going to fly, the next thing is to decide when. At busy airports like Gatwick and Manchester, Lancaster and SkyTours give you a choice of departure days and times. But the more civilised the hour, the more you'll have to pay. For instance, you can take off from Birmingham at 2:30 on a Saturday afternoon, but you'll have to pay an extra £39 for the privilege. A weekend flight from Glasgow will add as much as £50 per passenger. So if you want to save money and don't mind some long days travelling, go for a late night flight in the middle of the week. It may even pay you not to fly from your local airport, but to take a cheaper flight from one further afield. Going out at night is not too bad. Coming back is another story, with the cheapest flights taking off from Spain between 4 and 6 in the morning. That means hanging around your hotel until well after midnight without a room, unless your tour operator has made some arrangement. Once airborne, the passengers who paid £200 for their holidays are treated exactly the same as the ones who paid three times as much. Charter jets normally have only one class. Their seats are bought at bulk rates, so to make money, they have to fly very nearly full. And full means full, because a jet used for chartering will be fitted with as many seats as possible. This Boeing 737 can carry 130 passengers. If it was in service with a scheduled airline, it would take around 114. On charters, therefore, you get less legroom, and you can't take quite as much luggage. But at mealtimes, you'll still be fed for free. Drinks you have to pay for. The option of night flights is one way the budget holidays keep their prices down. Their selection of hotels is another. They use, in the main, one- and two-star hotels. The one-star Mysu is typical. Sky Tours and Broadway feature it. Both brochures describe it as friendly and informal. We found it popular with the guests we spoke to. It's towards the back of town, and while the brochures do say it's a bit of a walk from both the beach and the nightlife, they don't say you have to cross one of Benidorm's busiest roads, perhaps four times a day, because everyone's on full board and may well come back for lunch. The bedrooms are small and simply furnished, something to expect with a one-star hotel. They all have private bathrooms, some of them tight for space. There's a bar open from 9 one morning to 2 the next, and entertainment 5 nights a week, basically discos and bingo. They say the dining room will have waiter service this year, but of all the Mysu's qualities, the food arouses the least enthusiasm. Hardly surprising, perhaps, when all the company's budget on food is around £1 a day. What then does the Maisu cost? Our prices are for an adult on 14 nights full board with identical night flights from Luton, where there are no supplements to pay. They include insurance, on which the companies all insist. Broadway charges £197.50 in low season and £332.50 in peak summer. Sky Tours is easily the cheaper, going from £143.40 to £300.40. But then Sky Tours guarantee always to undercut their main competitors, Broadway and Lancaster among them. Find a cheaper, comparable holiday from a dozen rival brochures, and Sky Tours say they'll match the price. Lancaster and Broadway offer your money back if you find a better deal, but only after you've booked. Quite hard to find a holiday where other operators compete with Sky Tours head-to-head. There are only two other hotels in Benidorm where either Broadway or Lancaster take them on. The two-star Orange, Sky Tours share with Lancaster. The three-star Gala Perfidia, they share with Broadway. There are a few weeks when both the Lancaster and Broadway brochure prices are lower than Sky Tours. All three companies claim to have the guaranteed lowest prices. So if you can find a hotel that's shared, you can reckon its cost really will be rock bottom. And it does pay to make your own careful comparisons. A lot of families are attracted by these cheap holidays, and the companies compete fiercely with discounts for children. A child is aged from 2 to 11, according to Sky Tours, 2 to 12 with Broadway, and up to 18 on some Lancaster holidays. A number of free children's holidays, including some in high season, are offered as bait for early bookers. The discounts can be very complicated to work out, but they can make quite a difference to the price comparisons. This is what you'd pay for a 10-year-old sharing a room with two adults at the Maisu. In low season, £105.50 with Broadway and £46.65 with Sky Tours. But in high season, Broadway is cheaper, £173 against £214.60. That's because Broadway's children go half price throughout the summer. Those prices again include insurance. Overall, Lancaster have the most generous discounts for second children.